So let's have a look at the woodwinds contained in Synchronized Special Edition Volume 2, and we'll look at the flutes available here, starting with the second flute that complements the first flute in Volume 1 perfectly. And of course, you have long notes available here as well. With a nice vibrato coming in and the legato articulations. If you always wondered what the legato and the legato sus is, the legato, we recorded the note transitions from one starting note to the target note, and the target note always had a certain length, always depending on how much it made sense musically, and that's also the legatos that are available with the woodwinds here. And at some point, you have to breathe. If you know that you want to have a circular breathing, just go to the legato sustains. That means that you're after the note transition, you're switching to a sustained note that is looped, so it goes on forever. So that's the main difference between those two. You also get a sforzato with the flute. And of course, with a Volume 2 Plus, you get a lot more additional articulations. With the short notes, for example, you have a staccato, portato. You can switch between those easily. So you have an easy way to switch between articulations. The legato repetitions, always good to have. With authentic note transitions from one to the next note, so a round robin of long notes, and the staccato repetitions that are just really cool if you want to play more than, let's say, two notes or four notes right quick after each other, and you also have the note transition there. So you get the authentic note transitions there. You get the fortepiano additionally to the sforzato. And you get the trills, half-tone trills, and whole-tone trills. Fast repetitions. Faster. And on tempo 190. So that's the flute, the second flute with the Plus collection. As you know, in the mixer presets, you can always choose which kind of setup you want, close, distant, maybe the short reverberation with no convolution. Let's check out the distant position. You always see the position here. So my woodwinds, they're gonna be here right in the middle. And you can always see that with every instrument by clicking on that little button here. All right, let's check out what the alto flute sounds like. We go a little deeper than the normal flute. They have a very beautiful tone there with the alto flute, and we'll switch to the flute ensemble right away. That's the staccato right here. So you have the same articulations as always, just to give you an impression of what's in there. A little bit of the legato. Of course, with the flute ensemble, if you check out something like the trills, just loading in the plus articulations, just check out what the trills sound like, because there is a difference. Just get the whole, they are accurate, but of course it's still a group, and that kind of finds its way in there. So you get this warm, nice flute ensemble sound. So that's the flutes. Let's go to get to the oboes. And that's the Viennese oboe that is traditionally played without vibrato. Legato. Great sound and a nice addition to the French oboe. Let's check out the oboe d'amore, and you always see the range of the instrument. So this is the Viennese oboe, and the oboe d'amore has a slightly wider range. Or it's going a little bit further down. Legato again. Again, repetitions plus collection always pays off. If you go to the short notes and just play a few of the repeated notes. It's just nice to have those repetitions available whenever you need them. So for these kind of things, repetitions, great. Oboe ensemble, three players, staccato. So you have this kind of broadness that you get with an ensemble. Not 100% accurate, exactly what you want with an ensemble. So the legato as well, it just gets a little broader, warmer. All in all, it's a little bit, it's more powerful, but warmer. So that's the oboes, flutes, and oboes. We're coming to the clarinets. Clarinets in E flat. Very high range, actually plays very high. Legato, it's just the feature that you get with all our instruments. Now, if I want that to be a little bit closer or further away, I'm just going for the distant option. Again, my clarinets are here in the woodwinds, pretty central. Beautiful sound. And let's get to the clarinet in B flat 2. That's a very nice addition to the clarinet in B flat that you have in the volume 1. Very light footed, very simple to play. Beautiful instrument. Same as the basset horn, also a great sounding instrument. Of course, it's always a natural range of the instrument, but you can extend it if you want to. So if I needed this extra, these extra notes here in the staccatos, you just switch on the range view here, and you can, for the staccatos, just extend the range if you like to. just pitching the instrument or the samples in the background, but it gives you an additional range if you want to. So that's the Basset horn. Let's check out the legato here as well. Basset horn, also in the clarinet family, clarinet ensemble. The secret to a good string arrangement, add some woodwinds. Clarinets are done. Let's check out the bassoons. And that's just the three bassoons. Good addition to the bassoons that you have in the Special Edition Volume 1. Staccato. Legato. Exactly what you want from a bassoon ensemble. Let's get to the saxophones, alto, tenor, and baritone saxophone. Great to use for single notes, of course. You can also use it for, I don't know, if you want to warm up some bebop tunes, you could just start with playing a little bit of legato. And just replace some of the notes with other articulations or learn how to key switch between those, especially with jazz. It really is a different approach. Every instrument sounds different. Every player sounds a little bit different. And the phrasing is very important. You have a few of those in there and of those articulations, and you'll get more in the Plus collection. You get staccato repetitions, dynamics that you can always use to get more life into your performance. But it's more on the classical side of things. I'll just show you the fortepiano. You have some trills, you have some fast repetitions in there. So you can play with the alto saxophone, the typical sound. You can also use it for horn arrangements, of course, but it's not a dedicated funk section. The tenor saxophone. The legato, of course, also works. It's got a very nice soft touch to it. Baritone saxophone gives you all the roughness of the raw, of the lower notes. The warmness when you play the legato. So you got a very nice saxophone section in there as well, and that's the flutes, oboes, clarinets, and bassoons that are contained in the Synchronized Special Edition Volume 2.